Hello, Namaste, and welcome to Vino Asia, voice of the community. I'm Ashok Vyas, filling in for Aditi today. She's under weather. First Tuesday of 2019, great things are happening in the world. Many people are focused on their New Year resolutions. Let us sustain this momentum of doing good in 2019. In today's Vision of Asia, we'll have a look on some of the New Year celebrations from New Jersey, launch ceremony of South Asian Republican Coalition, and in review section, we'll have a report on dance drama Nandalala, 31st Benefit Gala and Deepavali celebration by Association of Indians in America, and Overseas Indian Congress event at Utsav Restaurant. Vision of Asia, a voice of the community, is shown on ITV Gold every Monday through Thursday at 8 p.m. and a special Vision of Asia with weekly roundup reaches you every Sunday at 11 a.m. Let us continue today's Vision of Asia right after this short break. New Year came at different time periods in different parts of the world. Some parts on earth preceded others in welcoming 2019. New Yorkers continued with the tradition of biggest party to welcome 2019 at the Times Square. Rain also couldn't dampen the spirit and enthusiasm to usher in a brand new year with so much festivities. And there were many New Year celebrations in New Jersey also. We caught up with community members ushering in 2019 with festivities. The collective mood of hope and joy is contagious. Here is a special look for ITV Gold with wishes for a great 2019. Happy New Year.
आप सबको नए साल की बहुत बहुत शुभकामनाएं. हैप्पी न्यू ईयर. सरदार खुश हुआ, साबा सीधे का नया साल मनाएंगे. जी हाँ दोस्तों, सुधीर पारिक जी को बहुत बहुत नए साल की, आईटीवी गोल्ड को बहुत बहुत शुभकामनाएं, और उनके जितने भी लोग हैं सबको बहुत बहुत मुबारकबाद. नया साल एक ऐसा वक्त होता है, एक ऐसा लम्हा होता है जब दिल से दिल मिलता है. और नया साल यानी कि 2019, विश यू ऑल द बेस्ट फॉर 2019. दिस इज कुलराज आनंद from the Radio Guru desk, wishing everybody, including Dr. Sudhir Parekh and everybody at ITV, आपको नए साल की शुभकामनाएं. मैं तो जा रहा हूँ एल्बर्ट पैलेस. आप भी आओ, मजे करेंगे, खाई पिएंगे, मस्ती करेंगे. टेक केयर, हैप्पी न्यू ईयर.
So you all are most welcome to Melbourne in 2019, and please come over.
My New Year resolution is to be in good health and to spend some quality time with friends and family.
Happy New Year, guys. Stay blessed. Keep rocking. Keep on your goals and work hard.
Happy New Year! Happy New Year!
just before the beginning of 2019, the excitement of 2018 also witnessed historic launch of South Asian Republican Coalition at Royal Albert Palace Restaurant in New Jersey. Stephen Rogers, chairman of American Winning Coalition and member of President's Advisory Board 2020, addressed the gathering. Padmashri Dr. Sudhir Parikh, chairman of ITV Gold and Parikh Worldwide Media, also shared his views about significant contributions made by President Trump. Here's the first part of ITV Gold's report on this event to launch South Asian Republican Coalition.
What it's made of, what's their, what they're looking for, what are their core principles, and what they want to bring into this country. So I'm a firm believer, I'm the staunch Republican, and I want it to grow among our Asians. We want to bring Mr. Trump back again in 2020 and beyond all, again and over again, Republican Party. So please join our cause. You can get the information on www.sarc.org.com or send the email to info@sarc.org.com and we'll definitely respond to you. Please come and join us.
Hi, this is Heaven Bhatt. We have been really very excited about this event today. This event we have been organizing since only for last few days and week. But then I'm very happy with the large community came here. And we have a vision to take this organization at the national level. And we want to make sure that mainstream America knows the existence of South Asian in America. And we want to make a difference in time to come. I really like that we have a lot of people with me, Mahant Bhai, then Mr. Yogesh Joshi, Samir, and Sonal. They have helped us in the event so much. And let me tell you this, the community has come together, and I am seeing an excellent and bright future in time to come. So I would be really telling everybody to make sure that please support us, and we are going to do the great job in time to come. Thank you so much.
Today, my personal dream came true. Those who are young generation, my Indian American friends do not know, but I was one of the few handful of the Indian American in early 90s were very active in the Republican Party. We were so active that during the George Bush Senior's campaign, we raised about $4 million. Wow. That time $4 million was a lot of money because our community was not that affluent. Our community was very small. This is 30 years ago. Then I'm the one who introduced New Jersey Republican Party to our community by doing the fundraiser for Christy Whitman, Governor Whitman. And that time no one knew about Governor Whitman. She was kind of underdog. And at my home, we invited 500 to 600 Indian Americans, those who came and supported Christy Whitman. And let me tell you that Republican administration always helps minority and Indian Americans, because I was the first Indian American physician, was appointed as a member of New Jersey Medical Licensing Board by Christy Whitman in 1993. And not only that, but again in 2013, first time any Indian physician was appointed second time to the New Jersey Licensing Board by Governor Christie. So that shows that Republican administration always care for our community. So that shows that always Republican administration, whether it's on state level or in a federal level, they always for India and Indian American community. Even today's Trump administration, as you know that we have sanctions against the Iran, but Trump has given, President Trump has given India a waiver to do the defense deal with the Iran, and that shows that President Trump is for India, and right now US-India relation again it gets a peak, and thanks to the President Trump.
Start with, I would like to congratulate Hemant Bhatt, Pinakin Pathak and SARC team for starting this very good community service for on the Republican Party side. Definitely we need a change. There has been too many talks going on of how do we empower Indian community. And yes, yeah, we Indians in generally, we will always lean on Democratic side. There's no need to lean on one party. Let's look for a change. Let's see who is doing good for us and let's go for that. And that's what we are all here for. Thank you very much. Thank you, ITV, for supporting such a nice event here.
We all know that we came from other countries. What happened there and what's happening. We don't want to go back. We don't want experience. We don't want our children, grandchildren, great-grandchildren to be under suppression what we went through. Thanks God, this country is the only country in the world that gave us the opportunities. Nobody else can fly their flag under the American flag. You can walk out to this country, put Indian flag, any other flag you wanted, because this flag is not afraid of the challenges of the other nations.
Indian American community, the South Asian community in New Jersey has ignited a torch that's going to go from coast to coast and around this country. And we thank God for what you're doing here. Thank you. I'm so grateful to be here with ITV, and I was on ITV several times, and I've got to tell you, the information and the news that ITV is bringing to people across this country is second to none, I've got to tell you, because you give people the opportunity to express their views, you give people real facts. We have a real problem in this country with fake news. You know what ITV does? Gives you facts, real news, and news that will be helpful not only to the people living and listening today, but to generations of Americans to come.
You're watching Vijayanovasia, Voice of the Community on IT Gold. Program continues right after these messages. Stay with us. Acclaimed dancer and choreographer, choreographed dance drama Nandalala, as the name suggests, this cultural and devotional drama shared the stories from the life of Lord Krishna. The performance of Nandalala was organized at Queensboro Performing Arts Center in September last year. This event was aimed at raising awareness and funds for Aim for Seva project conceived by Swami Dayananda Saraswati Ji, founder of Arsh Vidya Gurukulam. Another unique feature of this dance drama, it had combination of four styles of music, six forms of Indian classical dances, and incorporated songs in seven languages. Here is a report on Nandalala.
Finding the right balance between being careful about what is expected by the dance form and the bow.
Yeah. So while doing any character, you have to completely get into the character and be the character. So the first thing is to think that you are Krishna, you are playing the role of Krishna, and whatever the scene is, you have to get into it completely. So when my guru taught the role to me, she told me what emotions are supposed to come out and what I'm supposed to show in my face. She also shows me how it has to be done. So I've taken all that in and performed that on stage.
Yes, it was a wonderful experience altogether, working with this wonderful team, with our guru. The very important point is all of us are not from the same dance school. We're from different dance styles, from different parts of the country back in India. So all of us to get together, and we worked for nearly 6 months to bring out this finesse in this production. Our teacher has logged for nearly 24 hours every day, choosing the songs and teaching each person, like Rohini was telling, each person's character has to be exactly that. And we've played multiple roles, so we need to differentiate those characters in our head and be as apt as possible. So it has been an internal journey for all of us to bond, to bring out the characters, to bring out the vibrancy of the production and do justice to the roles we've played.
You have this wonderful mukut on your head. How that works out in terms of getting to the comfort zone?
Actually, when we rehearse at class, it's an entirely different comfort zone, because there's no lights on us, there's no jewelry, we're in our comfortable clothes. So we're definitely more confident back in class. But when we come on stage with especially few kiritams, which require a lot of detail, they are quite heavy. So there definitely is a hindrance to us to give our full 100%, but we definitely try to put in, and our guru always says, only if you give 1000% in class, at least 10% of that comes in stage.
It was wonderful working in this production because it was a multilingual production. It doesn't confine to the norms of the other productions we've done because it's multilingual, and although majority of this is Bharatnatyam, we've also taken and adapted from different styles of dance. So it was really new to take in the nuances, because I think usually when we're doing Bharatnatyam, we're so focused on that we fail to, you know, sometimes understand or comprehend the other nuances of the other forms. So I think that way is very enriching.
Association of Indians in America hosted 31st annual gala and Deepavali celebration at Great Neck, New York. This well-organized event brought enthusiastic community members together. Accomplished professionals were recognized. ITV Gold and Parikh Worldwide Media Chairman Padma Shri Dr. Sudhir Parikh also supported AIA. Here is a part of our report.
This means a lot, essentially, because your own community is the last one, and it truly means a lot. I'm grateful to my family, I'm grateful to my friends, quite a few of them are here, so thank you very much for your support, your patience, and Mr. Ujjal, I will be available for any kind of assistance to the AIA that you may require. So thank you very much.
And I'm really humbled by AIA Executive Committee to consider me for this event.
I want you to share the secret how you managed to mingle and embrace community members at so many different events. Yesterday you were at Asia Society.
Well, I mean, I love the community, and I always believe that one has to be give back to the community, and that's what I'm doing it. I'm doing it with my time, my resources, financial resources, and with my media. The whole idea is to give back to the community, and I'm really enjoying it. It's for me, it's a adrenaline. I mean, it makes me very happy to see community grow and happy. You won't believe that I'm associated with the AIA since 1993. That is 30 years ago. And the first time they started elephant ride, and I was one of the sponsor of the ride for children. So I believe in this thing, and I truly enjoy this thing. And I urge everyone else to be part of the community and support the community.
So today there were some wonderful honorees. Some of the speeches were quite inspiring. Any impressions that you would carry from here?
Yeah, I mean, I see that what I was 40 years ago and what I was trying to achieve, I achieved 30, 40 years ago, I see in this young generation here. And it's a... And I'm very happy to see that our second generation is working hard, and they are excelling, and they are doing well.
Rajiv Gowda, member of Rajya Sabha Government of India, was present in New York at an event hosted at Utsav Restaurant by Indians Overseas Congress. He was in New York as a part of the delegation brought by FICCI, Mr. Gowda said Congress is committed to uphold the idea of inclusiveness under the leadership of Congress President Rahul Gandhi. Here is a review of that report.
Raj Gowda, who is a member of the Rajya Sabha, is here. And in 2019, we are going to meet in 2019. So, ज़्यादा करके सारे स्टेट के लोग यहाँ पे आए हुए हैं. महाराष्ट्र के हैं, महाराष्ट्र अपना दिल्ली से भी है, पंजाब से है, यूपी से है, सारे लोग हम लोग मिले हुए हैं यहाँ पे उत्सव रेस्टोरेंट के अंदर. सो वी आर गोइंग टू डू वेरी मच क्लोजली मीटिंग विद द पीपल एंड वेरी सून वी आर गोइंग टू द विन ऑल द इलेक्शन. आई प्राउड ऑफ यू मिस्टर राज गौड़ा इज ए फ्रॉम राज्यसभा. सो थैंक यू सो मच एंड आई एम गुड लक टू एवरीबडी टू.
We are looking forward for the session with Rajiv Gowda MP from Karnataka, and we all respect IOC for the inclusiveness and secularism that it stands for, and we are we hope, you know, that Congress will come into power, and we all have to work hard for that in the coming years. For the next year, the Congress should come into power in the parliament.
So this evening, it's an honor and privilege to be spending the evening with members of the Congress party overseas. And we have a range of people from different professions who come from different parts of New York City and its suburbs. And they're honoring me with a chance to engage with them on how to strengthen the Congress party and how to improve our prospects in the forthcoming election. I have been here as part of a delegation of MPs brought to America by FICCI, the Chamber of Commerce Association. And I'm at the end of a very, very intense and productive series of engagements in Berkeley, in San Jose, in Los Angeles, and in New York. Just before coming here, I gave a talk at Columbia University on electoral reforms. And essentially, this evening, we are gathered to reinforce our commitment to India, to the idea of India, which stands for inclusion, for celebration of diversity, for attention to those who are left behind. And this is what the Congress has always stood for and will continue to stand for as we basically take things forward, you know, under Sri Rahul Gandhi's leadership.
As we move towards the concluding part of today's Vision of Asia, Voice of the Community, let me request, do become friend of the ITV Gold page on Facebook and have access to our live shows as well as other programs. Do share details of events@itvgold.com and subscribe to ITV Gold's YouTube channel. And now, here is a reminder. The expression, time flies, is supported by experience of many people. In a wink, time flies. Especially when we lose focus, it goes away from us without proper shake hand or goodbye. To make the most of 2019, let's always be alert and in tune to our goals and aspirations with firm commitment to realize our resolutions. Well, on that note, paying due respect to time, promising to have another episode of Vision of Asia on ITV Gold tomorrow at 8 p.m. This is Ashok Vyas.